Hello, my name is Morten and I'm an instructor at FURUNO Maritime Training. One of you guys sent us a very interesting question. He's doing his route planning somewhere in Japan and he asks, I got so many alarms, can I turn off safety contour alarm? What is this restricted alarms all the time and caution alarms all the time? So I would like to explain on the ECDIS what you can do to minimize the alarms and why you cannot turn off the safety contour alarm. So now we are here on the ECDIS, and as you can see, I'm also in the planning mode here. And first of all, you get a lot of alarms. When you have checked your route after you planned it, then you check your route and you get a lot of alarms. On this list, you get all the alarms there is on your route. The thing you can do is you can go into alert parameters, this page. Then you can highlight what is your safety contour, your UKC limit, your draft. And then you can put tick marks on the alarms you want presented in on your chart on your route plan. So then you will get presented where the alarms that is important to you will be. So you have the list here, but here you have tick mark what is important to you. So maybe the list is long here, but if you highlight it here, then it's more easy to, okay, then it will highlight your problem areas. And then you can say, okay, for example, here I have as you can see here, it's colored red. That means it's a safety contour alarm. You cannot, and I stress out, the safety contour alarm is a safety alarm for you. It's for your safety. This is so you don't ground your ship. So you cannot avoid it. Yeah, you can avoid it. You can see here, you could might narrow down the canal a little bit. But here I did something else. I use my spot soundings instead to highlight the problem areas. You see, when it's in black color, that means it's below my safety values. You see, I have the safety contour here, but it's in gray. That means it's higher than my safety contour alarm. So it means I can actually cross this area without even breaching my safety contour value. So you have these things you can play a little bit around with. So of course it's you have to, as you can see, this is your route. So you're actually not, it will be in your XTD limit, but you can pass without even breaching the area. So you have to use the alarms instead of seeing them as a problem. Then you say another question was the restricted area and caution areas. If you listen to the word restricted areas, that means that you are sailing in an area where there are restrictions. So you can right click and then you can check the pig report and then you can see, okay, here, I don't know, I don't think I have any restriction. I see I have a restricted area here. Then click it and then see what the restriction is. Okay, I can see the restriction is, says nothing, category of restricted area. That means it's a PSSA area. Okay, there's nothing more, it's not that dangerous. Okay, then if you have the caution area, you can click and you can see what the caution area and read it. Instead of thinking of it as a nuisance, then use it in your route planning. Okay, I hope this was enough explanation about this. It all comes down to alarm management and not seeing the alarms as a nuisance, using them to give you the best picture, the safest picture. So I hope this was enough explanation on this question for you who sent the question. And for the rest of you, I really, really want to thank all of you who sent in questions. This makes this small videos more fun. to explain about on this ECDIS. So send me some questions, okay? And thank you, and look on our social media pages, send some questions for us, and see you next time.